Alzheimer's disease falls under the dementia umbrella. It causes a slow decline in memory, thinking, and reasoning skills. There are 10 warning signs and symptoms that the Alzheimer's organization put together. Doctor, if you will, let's go through these one at a time. And if you would, mention if this is also a typical age-related change and how someone can tell the difference.
Right. So the first thing, as I was saying before, if you forget where your keys are, that's not such a big deal. But if you, like I say, leave the car keys in the car, or the car running, or water running, or the stove on, and leave the house, that's a little more significant. And again, we talked about planning and solving problems as part of it, difficulty completing familiar tasks. So if somebody can't remember how to turn on the washing machine or turn on the television, that wouldn't be an example. People obviously can get disoriented at time or place. They may not know where they are, what year it is. And we also touched briefly upon seeing people's faces. They may not be able to recognize people's faces. And again, just in terms of spatial relationships.
There's a few things here that we didn't really touch on. Poor judgment is part of it, too, and you withdraw from your work and social activities. And the change in mood and personality. I think number 10 is a big one, because I have had firsthand experience in seeing that happen.
Yeah, a typical story is somebody used to be a very nice person. Now they're being aggressive towards family members and losing their temper easily. That can be a clue to dementia.
How do you diagnose Alzheimer's, though, with so many symptoms?
It's very hard to diagnose. There's no blood test for it. There's no X-ray or MRI results that are classic for Alzheimer's. Really, you have to spend time with the patient and go through a whole complex series of testing. Usually it takes a few hours and is often done in hospital centers that specialize in dementia.